in this time of coronavirus pandemic, as 1 million people are infected with the coronavirus, many people are fearful, they're afraid, they are having a lot of stress. What I will say is, be fearful of the virus, be fearful of the humans who may carry the virus in them, but don't be afraid of the outdoors. All the things in nature, the sun, the trees, the air, the sky, all these are our friends, and time spent in outdoors is important for our mental and physical health. I will talk about ways where we can spend time outdoors without increasing the risk of the coronavirus infection. If you get infected by coronavirus, 75% of the people will have no symptoms, yet they can still spread the virus for about 2 weeks. So it's very important that at this time, human-to-human contact is minimized. All the government agencies and health organizations are urging people not to leave their house, to avoid large gatherings. Make sure you don't come in contact with other person. Now, the other person may not have any symptoms. They may not have fever. They may not have cough. They may be absolutely healthy and look normal. Yet, they may have the virus inside their body and you can get infected to it without knowing. The hope is, as less people meet with each other, the virus will have less opportunity to spread from one person to the other, and over the time, the virus will go away. But now the problem is staying inside is not an easy thing. We don't know how long this will last. As a psychiatrist, a lot of my patients have already started complaining that as they're staying inside the house, they're watching TV all day, they're eating all junk food, and they are getting more depressed, they are getting more anxious, their stress levels are going high, they feel claustrophobic, they feel suffocated, they cannot sleep at night. And all these are true. All these are the hazards of staying indoor all the day. Our body evolved to be outside, to be in the sun, through million years of evolution. When you stay inside, our circadian rhythm, the rhythm which controls our sleep-wake cycle, the rhythm also controls our hunger pattern, also controls our release of hormones. When we stay inside and do not get access to the natural light, all this gets disturbed. As a result, you can have sleep problems. One can have more craving for junk food, fatty food, carbohydrates. And also physically, you get less exercise when you are indoors. Depending on how many rooms you have, how many times you can walk back and forth, how many times you can climb the stairs from one place to the other. Lack of exercise also has its own physical and mental problems. So in this video, I am going to talk about how you can be outside, you can be outdoors, yet without having the increased risk of the coronavirus infection. If you live in a big house, if you have access to a big backyard, patio, make full use of it. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, spend a good amount of time outdoors. Ideally, I say we should spend at least one third of our time under the natural light condition. The second is, if you are not living in a house but you are living in an apartment or town, you can still have access to outdoors. Like I'm doing this video, I live in an apartment, so I'm just standing near the parking lot and I'm still getting outdoor light without leaving my house. You can walk in your parking lot. If you have a community, if you have a park or something that is open, you can still go and walk there. The key thing is, make sure that you avoid contact with other people. If you see somebody coming in front of you, that may be a friend, that may be a neighbor, you may know that person, but you are not sure whether the person has coronavirus or not. So keep the 6 feet distance. The 6 feet distance has been recommended by the health organizations, and it seems that the 6 feet is a safe and effective distance and the virus will not travel within that distance. Sometimes if there are too many people and if it is too much crowded, maintaining that 6 feet safe distance is always not possible. To be on the safer side, I will recommend wearing a mask. There are several kinds of masks. The N95 is the recommended one against the coronavirus, but during this time it is very hard to find. Don't worry, any mask will provide you some sort of protection. So it's always better to wear some protective mask than wearing nothing. But if you're just outside and you cannot see anybody nearby, you don't need the mask. For children, it is very hard for them to stay inside. Adults, we struggle, but children struggle the most. The problems with focus, attention, irritability, anger outbursts, temper tantrums, and other behavioral problems can get worse as the children are staying inside. So try to take them out, but keep in mind to avoid contact. Now, a word of caution. If you are sick, under no condition leave the house. Stay indoors, that's okay. Wait till you fully recover. And when you are going outdoors, one point is do not touch anything. Although the virus is transmitted through air droplets, when we cough, when we sneeze, but the virus can still stay on some object for some hours, so it's better not to touch them. Carry a hand sanitizer so that you can wash your hands. And the other point is, if you decide to leave your house, don't go far away. So the key is to get some outdoor exposure, to get the natural light on your body, to get some exercise, to get some fresh air. You don't have to go farther away from the house. There are many advantages of spending some time outside. The natural light which comes from the sun plays a key biological role in our body. The blue light from the sun sets up the circadian rhythm in our body. It tells our body when it is the time to wake up and when it is the time to sleep. The red light from the sun that helps with the energy production in our body, that stimulates the mitochondria to produce more ATP. And most importantly, the ultraviolet light from the sun helps in vitamin D production, and vitamin D helps in multiple processes. It helps in preventing cancer, it helps in weight loss, it helps in diabetes, it helps in inflammation. All the body processes benefits by vitamin D. Then the sun also contains an infrared light. We do not see it, but we feel it. It helps in pain relief, it increases the circulation, it helps in skin rejuvenation. And a lot of the times, if you have some injury in your body, some pain in your body which is not healing, the infrared light from the sun can help in that. In the end, I want to summarize that although the instruction is to stay home, not to leave the house, you can still be outside safely if you follow these following precautions. If you decide to be outside, choose a time of the day when you are less likely to come in contact with other people, or choose a spot where there are no other people. Don't go too far away from your house. Walk nearby. If you see somebody coming, move away. Keep a 6 feet distance. If there are too many people and you are not sure you can keep the safe distance or not, wear your mask. Do not touch any object as you are outside. If you do, carry a hand sanitizer with you. Wash your hands. Every time you leave the house and you come back inside the house, wash your hands.